Welcome to the Church of St. John Nepomucene here in Bohemia, New York, where we gather to celebrate the seventh Sunday in Easter. Our presider today is our pastor, Father Joe Schlafer, and our lector is Ernie Dench. We begin in song with number 569 in the Breaking Bread hymnal. If you have one with you at home, please sing with us, Join in the Dance, number 569.
Let us pray. Graciously hear our supplications, O Lord, so that we, who believe that the Savior of the human race is with you in your glory, may experience, as he promised, until the end of the world, his abiding presence among us, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked up intently to heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And Stephen said, "Behold, I see the heavens opened, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they cried out in a loud voice, covered their ears, and rushed upon him together. They threw him out of the city and began to stone him. The witnesses laid down their cloaks at the feet of a young man named Saul. As they were stoning Stephen, he called out, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he fell to his knees and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." And when he said this, he fell asleep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Receive the gift of life-giving water. The one who gives this testimony says, yes, I am coming soon. Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The comment is often made that we live in a small world because of the instantaneous way of getting in touch with each other. People say the world continues to shrink as our ability to connect becomes easier and faster with each passing day. But I have a question. Is all of this high-tech communication really what it means to be connected to each other? In today's gospel, Jesus speaks about all of us being connected, in fact, being united, but on a much deeper level than simple communication. In today's gospel, Jesus is praying to the Father, not only for his disciples, but as he says, for those who will believe in me through the words of the disciples. And then his prayer is so that all may be one. All may be united. All may be connected. As we read on in the gospel, we find that the kind of oneness or unity that Jesus is praying for is based on love. Love for Jesus is the most real way to be connected to God, and therefore love is the deepest and most powerful reality that connects us to each other. Not cell phones, not texts or emails, but love. This is what he says in the gospel. Father, I have made known to my disciples your name, so that the love with which you loved me may be in them. In other words, beyond our modern and high-tech means of communication, Jesus is saying that the real measure of being connected to each other is how faithful we are in loving one another. The real measure of being connected is how open we are in our hearts to making the decisions that love compels us to make. So, having read that gospel, having thought about it, I put together a few questions that for myself are a challenge to ask myself, how connected am I really to the Lord and to his people? Here's some of the questions. How willing am I to always forgive another person? How hard do I work at refraining from judging or criticizing another person? How eager and ready am I to reach out to the needs of another? How committed am I to working toward peace and justice? How patient am I in enduring my own imperfections, but especially in going through and enduring the imperfections of other people? How eager am I to work on my own faults so that I don't allow my weaknesses to become a burden to those around me? How often do I consider the needs of others before I consider my own needs? Why am I listing all these questions? I think because these questions have to do with love. And the answers that I can give to those questions will determine how truly connected I am to other people. And I think that's what Jesus is praying for in today's gospel, that all may be one, because Father, I have given them the love that you gave me. And that's how we will be united as a human family. You know, as we read this gospel and hear the Lord's prayer to the Father, let's remember we live in a world where many individuals and many religious and political groups and even many nations are very often disconnected from each other. reasons why Jesus' prayer for unity in today's gospel is all the more timely and compelling and urgent. No matter who and where we are in life, it is the task of each of us to connect with others. And how? By means of love in all of its forms. Today's gospel is an invitation to work for the unity of love which Jesus prays for. And as we work for that unity, we are called to break down the walls that divide us personally, politically, religiously, nationally, globally. We're called to work for unity. One example of how we can do it is simply to imitate Christ. For he was the Lord and Savior of the whole human race. He came to his Jewish people in order to come to all of humanity. We need to imitate him. We need to be imitating his openness, his embrace of every human being. And when I say imitate him, I think of today's first reading. It's the story of Stephen, who traditionally is thought of as the first deacon of the church and the first martyr. And if you read the story of Stephen, it is such an echo of the story of Jesus. He was accused of blasphemy, as Jesus was accused. He was charged with false accusations, as Jesus was. He was arrested and brought before the Sanhedrin. It's all an echo of what happened to Stephen's Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And then, as he's being stoned to death, he issues two statements that are beautiful echoes of what Jesus said on the cross. Stephen is being stoned to death, and he says, "Lord, don't hold this sin against them." Remember what Jesus said on the cross, "Father, forgive them, they know not what they do." And then Stephen says, "Father, into your hands I commend my spirit." Almost word for word, the statement of Jesus on the cross, "Father, into your hands I entrust my spirit." Stephen was what we're all called to be, an imitation of Jesus, an echo of his love. And if we can imitate Jesus, we can accomplish this unity that Jesus is praying for. The reason that wars and tragedies touch our hearts so deeply is we instinctively know that we must be part of one human family. And the tragedies of life that touch us in our society disrupt that unity. The Eucharist that we come to at the Lord's table is the place where we celebrate being united to every other human being in a sacramental way. Let's just pray that the gift of his body and blood will help us to break down the barriers that separate us, whether it's one person from another or one nation from another. Let's pray because of his prayer for unity, that the human family will really become God's family by all of us being connected by the daily task of selfless love. It's only that kind of love that can bring lasting unity and true peace to our world. My friends, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting in the constant care of our loving Father in heaven, we turn to the Lord with our needs and prayers.
Our response is, Risen Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, especially in this Easter season, may our faith in Jesus Christ renew us and attract those who do not yet believe. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in authority, may the Holy Spirit bless them with an abundance of understanding and prudence, that they may achieve peace for all people. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For the children in Texas who lost their lives, may God bless them with the fullness of life in heaven, and for their families, that they may find healing and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick and who have asked for our prayers, especially Father Larry, Al Jacobson, Theodore Paul, Christopher Haneen, and all those who suffering from any kind of chronic illness or addiction, and to the sick whose names we now mention aloud, that they may receive comfort and healing, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who care for the sick, for all those working for the distribution of vaccines, and that their efforts may result in greater health for all people, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Bishop Camille Cello, Nicholas Gennaro, and for all who have lost their lives in any war or conflict, especially the people of the Ukraine, and for those whose names we now mention aloud, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who remember in a special way at this Mass today, and for the intentions that are unspoken within our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer. God of light and love, hear and answer our prayers today according to your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Please join us in the singing of number 519, By Our Love, number 519.
Thank you.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
But accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Give them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in this season of Easter and Ascension, we believe that the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, Jesus ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with Easter joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life, and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, all the clergy, and all of your beloved people, remember our brothers and sisters who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have gone to their rest in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. May the blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life. Amen.
Our communion psalms, number 332, taste and see, number 332.
Through the universe, display.
Hear us, O God, our Savior, and grant us confidence that through these sacred mysteries there will be accomplished in the body of the whole Church what has already come to pass in Christ, her head, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. My friends, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God always bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to glorify the Lord by our lives. Thanks be to God. Thank you for being with us for this prayer, and have a great week.
In honor of Memorial Day, our closing hymn will be America the Beautiful, verses 1 and 3. It's number 745 in the hymnal, verses 1 and 3.